Okay guys, today I'm going to give this Quark M1 a new battery. The battery you need is a 3-volt lithium and it's a CR2032. Okay, we are going to turn this upside down. We are going to unscrew maybe 30 screws so we can get to the other side of the main PCB. And on the PCB is a battery holder and it's very easy to replace the battery. I have to give one warning. Because if you replace the battery, everything that is in the memory will be gone. So if you have important sequence stuff inside, please make a backup first. Okay, if I want to do the factory reset using cards, I can use three different cards. This is the first one. It is the MPC00P. It's the original program and combination card. It has 100 sounds and 100 combinations. It came together with this second card. It is the MPC00S. This one contains the original demo songs, like the Oh Yes song. And the last one I'm also using today is the MPC0EX. And this card came with the extension, the M1EX extension. And this card is pretty rare, but I'll also show how to use this card and what it will put inside the machine. To load the presets onto the Quark M1, I need an interface with the computer. I'm going to use this Phonic FireWire interface. It has MIDI in and MIDI out, and it is bus powered over FireWire, so I need a FireWire cable. I'm going to use this one, and I need a MIDI cable, and that's this one. This is enough to do the transfer. You could also use a USB MIDI interface if you're on a more modern machine. The last we need is, of course, a new battery. I found this one at a local shop, only 99 cents for 5 batteries. So that gives me enough batteries for 25 more years of Quark M1. Okay guys, I'm going to open up the M1. This is usually the cloth that is on top of it to protect it from dust. I'm going to put it underneath so the synthesizer won't get a scratch from the table. What I also do is that I put the synthesizer a little bit over the edge so that this stick won't damage. Of course, I removed the mains so I won't get a shock when diving into this machine. Okay, the M1 is upside down. It's time to unscrew. All the screws are plain Phillips, so it's not a big deal, but it will take some time. The reason I'm not using an electric screwdriver is that usually the screws are made of brass or steel, and the cabinet itself is made from aluminium, and aluminium is very soft metal. So if you unscrew with an electric screwdriver, you have the risk that you will kill the thread in the aluminium. The screws are out. I can wiggle a bit and it will get the bottom cover off. Okay, this is the inside. Here we have the main board with the battery. We have to unscrew that one as well. With these screws, I found out they are not all the same. So what I do, I put them down in the order that I have them in the board. These two are a bit longer. These are the screws that hold the vertical card slot in place. So the board is loose now. To put it over to the side, I need to disconnect two wires. One wire is here on the power supply, and one is here, and it is the connection to the keyboard. And now it is pretty easy to lift the board over to the side. Okay, this is the main PCB, and here is our battery holder. Okay, this is the battery cell. To get it out, you slightly slide it upwards. Then you can lift it up
and replace it with a fresh one. Alright, the board is back in place. All I need to do is to put these cables back. So this one goes there and this one goes back here.
Everything is back in place, all the screws are back, the battery is replaced, and if I boot it up now, it has nothing in the memory. So we need to install the factory sounds and the factory sequences to this machine. Cork gave us two ways of doing so. The first is by using the cards, and the other way is to do it with MIDI. Cork gave two cards with this machine. The first one is the MPC00P, and the second card is the MPC00S. How does this work? First, we install the program card. Okay, this is how to install from a card. Insert the card. I'm on the global menu. I'm going a couple of pages. This is an important one. The program memory is not protected. The combination memory is not protected. This one is important. We have to have it on 100, 100, 4400, otherwise the information from the cards won't fit. And MIDI data dump, it's not needed. Load from card, this is what we are going to do. So I have the program card now. Load, yes, okay, completed. If I put it on program now, we see the universe sound again. And on combination, we see the film score. I'm going to load the song now. Insert the other memory card, going back to global, going to the last page, and it already says sequence because it sees that I have the sequence card. Are you sure? Okay, yes. And now you can start playing the Oh Yes song. You see it's here. I can press start and it starts playing. Now I'm going to load the EX sounds. Inserting the EX program card, I'm going to global, going to the page. Memory is not protected, the combination memory is not protected, so I can load from the card, yes. And if I put on program, it now says One World, and this was the number one sound for the EX or the T series. And on the combination, it should say Cosmic Rain. So the upgrade from the card has succeeded. What to do if you want to do it with MIDI? As I said, you need SysX Librarian. I will put a link to both the software and the libraries that you can download at Cork. Okay, this is the website by Kurt Revis. He made a very nice MIDI tool for the Mac system. And the nice thing about this website is that it contains a lot of versions that go back very far. So even on a vintage machine like this, you can use it. It goes back to OS X 10.1 up to the latest Mojave. So every Mac is catered for. For this specific machine, I need to get a little bit an older version. Here it says, if you want to use it on a PowerPC Mac, get version 1.2.3, that's what I'm going to download. Okay, I downloaded the program, it's a disk image file, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to double click this. You can also drag it to your application folder. Before I can continue, I have to tell the Macintosh that I have a Cork M1 connected. And to do so, I open the Audio MIDI program. When you boot it up, you see this. The Firefly 302 is here, but it's not connected to anything yet. So I'm going to add a synthesizer. You can double click it. You can choose a nice image. This one, for example.
and I will call it core M1. Okay, that's the name. And now I have to make the connection. I can drag a line from the output of the Firefly to the input of the M1. So now Mac OS X knows that I've made the connection to my synthesizer. I'm going to boot up a SysX librarian now. Close this, open it. And here you see that the M1 is connected. Okay, we also need to download the presets from Korg. If you go to the Korg website and you choose support and then downloads, and you go to the legacy machines, you will find the Korg M1. And you can download this file. It's a zip file and it contains the files you need to do a factory reset. Okay, here is the download from Korg. If you double click it, it opens. It's a folder. And you see it has three files in it. What we need is the SYX file, and I'm going to drag it onto this screen. Don't warn me again. And now you see the preload file is in the software. And all I need to do now is to run it to my M1. There are a couple of things to check if you do it over MIDI. I'm going to the global menu. I am going to the page that says something about MIDI. You see here that it has a MIDI filtering option, and what this does, it's kind of a firewall for MIDI, so you can block certain MIDI messages from disturbing your work. The default is that system exclusive data is blocked, so we have to enable this, and now it will listen to system exclusive data. Okay, and to send it to your Korg, you just press play. And you can see it takes a little bit. The speed is not up to USB-C standards. And now it is uploading the data to the M1. And how can you see? Because buttons are blocked right now. Okay, the MIDI transfer has finished. I press program and you can see it has the original sound universe. And on the sequencer, you also see the Oh Yes song, and we can play that. How can you make a backup? We add a second cable from the M1 back to the audio interface. We go to global menu, we go to the end. Here it says MIDI data dump. You can choose what you want to dump, the program, the combination, the global data, the sequencer data, all data. So I'm going to make a backup of all data. And what I do then is I'm going to hit record on the computer. And now I hit dump. And right now it is sending the MIDI data back to the computer. Okay, thanks for watching. This was a small video about the replacement of the battery on this M1. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel. There will be more videos about my handheld collection, video games on one side, and about 80s music gear on the other side. Hope you enjoyed, and see you again soon.